So, when was the first time, right? When was the first time that you listened, you actually listened to hip hop? You got into it heavy. You know what I mean? When was the first time like you heard hip hop and you were like, damn, this is the shit. You know what I mean? When was that? When did that happen for you?
Well, yeah, 15 or 14, something like that. And I heard, I think it was Snoop Dogg, like the first rapper I ever heard. Man, he was just off the hook. And then, I don't know, man, then I heard Bone. My mom bought me like a CD or something for Christmas, a Bone. And I was like, man, this is off the motherfucking hook. So, you know, after that, I just started writing my own lyrics. And I just fell in love with it, man. All
right. How about you, Dragon?
I was like 9 years old. Man, I was like 9 years old when I started listening to rap music. I mean, my brother, yeah, he came home and shit with a CD. It was actually like one of Bone's real older CDs. It was like Faces of Death or whatever, and I first heard that. Man, I was just hooked to it. Man, I was feeling it. I was mad into that stuff. And then I started trying to practice freestyles and whatnot. When I became 11, I started writing my own lyrics and stuff, trying to do that, but didn't really get the hang of that till I was like 13, and then just went on from there and started recording at like 14.
That's cool, cool, cool. So you started recording at 14. All right, man, what about you? What about you, Flosja? When did you start recording?
Man, I started recording like last year, as a matter of fact.
Okay, okay. So you just, that's cool. I haven't heard, you know what I'm saying? I heard some of your music, but I haven't heard a lot of it. But, you know what I'm saying? Sounds like you got it pretty together already. So, no, I mean, I guess you got it naturally.
Thanks, man. You want something bad enough, man, you just do what you better do to get it, you know what I'm saying?
I hear you. I hear that, man. All right, man, we're going to go into some other questions. I know for a fact that Bone is one of your influences, you know what I mean? But are there any others, you know what I'm saying? Who else influenced you, you know what I'm saying, while you're doing your music? What are some of your other influences?
Man, well, another influence, man, I'd have to say Snoop, he was another one. Man, back then, they were just doing it up, man. I had to, that was even before Eminem or whatever came out, but he's like, right now, it's like one of my big influences, because he's like achieved so much in like a shorter time. It's like amazing with this cat does, and he's like underrated as far as like people see him as a, you know, as a stereotype of the race thing. And once you get past that part, I think he's done like the best so far, like 2002, you know. But as for other influence, yeah, Bone, you know, that's a given. But yeah, Brother Lynch too, he was mad ill. And yeah, I said that's about it.
Alright, what about you, Flosja?
I guess, man, Snoop, of course, he's the first one I ever heard. And then when I heard Crazy Bone stuff and Bone, all Busy Bone stuff and all them, man, it's just like, that really helped, that really made me want to do it a lot. And then, like, I got real deep into it and everything, and just motherfuckers hating and all that, and really thinking that I can't do it, and, like, because where I come from and everything, because I come from a small place. They think that I can't make it and stuff, and it's really made me determined to show them, you know. That's really, that's a big influence.
Alright, cool, cool, cool. Alright, so, what are some of the projects that, you know, y'all got going? Solo and as a group.
Well, me right now, which mine will probably be dropping first, because I'm like farther into, I'm deeper into my CD or whatever. It's gonna be called Hellcon the Dragon. And as far as that, that's gonna have like at least 18 or 21 tracks on it. And you could be looking for that around, man, I wouldn't even say summertime, way before that probably. And yeah, Flo, you can go ahead and talk about your little project.
Well, man, I just got that Best Kept Secret album about to drop probably around summertime.
Cool, cool.
And then together, yeah, but together we got that got that lethal injection. We finna hit him off with. Man, I'm not sure when that's gonna come around, but I think it's probably gonna be after our lo-fi albums drop, because we like in the beginning of it, you know?
Alright, so, yeah, I got you.
You can expect that.
Cool. So y'all both got like solo projects going in the workings. I know Dragon's got a few tracks already. I've heard, you know, I heard like one of his albums already. All right, man.
Yeah.
What do you think right now of the hip hop scene, and what changes do you want to bring to it? As you know what I'm saying, as a group, really. So as solo artists and as groups, you know, as a group, what do you, you know, like both y'all could hit me up with the answer on that.
Okay, like me personally, I think
game.
Yeah, no doubt. That's
slinging and all that fake stuff. Shit that don't mean nothing, man. I do music because it's real. I like to be real with my stuff, man. I like to talk about all that material stuff don't mean shit.
I was just about to say the same thing, man. You be thinking the same. But I guess great minds think alike, but man, this fake stuff. Man, this fake stuff, man. I'm not feeling that, because it was cool for a little bit. You know, they got the little shining bling bling going on, but man, step out the way. I mean, real lyricists gotta step through, you know, spitting that ill stuff. I mean, like, right now, the underground stuff is the real shit right now, because ain't nobody really saying nothing in the game.
When they ain't getting paid, they just do this fun. This is my motherfucking life. You know what I'm saying? I do this shit because I love it. I ain't doing it just to get a paycheck.